हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू क्लाउड अक्षय डॉट कॉम। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी दैट व्हाट इज द फाइल एडिटर टूल्स इन लिनक्स सिस्टम। सो देर आर फोर टाइप्स ऑफ फाइल एडिटर लाइक वी आई और द विम एंड द कैट एंड नैनो। ओके, एंड वी कैन ऑल्सो यूज एज अ टच। ओके, सो लेट्स सी। हेलो वरुण। हेलो।
अच्छे, यू कैन हियर यू।
ओके ओके, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी दैट हाउ टू एडिट इन फाइल इन लिनक्स। ओके, सो वी हैव मल्टीपल वे टू एडिट और क्रिएट अ फाइल इन टू द लिनक्स। सो वी आर गोइंग टू सी इन अवर प्रैक्टिकल। एंड फर्स्ट So there are four file editor or the file viewer in Linux. They can be multiple, but the basic is four. So first see the cat command. Okay, so our command is cat, and let's see how can we do with the cat command. So this is my Linux machine. I'm logged in. So let's create some file with cat command. I entered cat cat and the file name I make a file with Aman name. Okay, and hit enter. So there is no data and directory. Okay, so there is no file. So to create Aman file, so we need to put here greater than file create and insert some data in Aman file. Hit enter. So here is the cursor. I insert data in that. So I write today's file editor session, and to save and exit from this editor, so we need to press Control plus D. Okay, so Aman file is created, and today's file editor session, this is the data of the Aman file, and it is saved with Control and D command. Control plus D. Okay, so let's see once again cat and Aman. So this is my file data. Okay, and it is used for to create file, and it is also used for the add multiple data into one file. Okay, and also copy text file into the another file, and also we can do the tag. Okay, let's make some more file cat. I make one more file here, cat greater than Sumit. Okay, hit enter. So day two is there. I write data that day two is there, and Control D for saved it. My data is saved. So let's see data once again. Okay, if I write two lines into the Sumit comma in Sumit file, so let's write how to edit existing file with cat command. Cat double greater than, okay, and the Sumit. So here I can write some extra data like day three is next, I write day 3 is next and let's save and exit. Okay, and let's check the tag command TAC. TAC is reverse of cat. So TAC and Sumit. First, let's see the Sumit. What data in Sumit? Cat, Sumit. So there is two data. Day 2 is there and day 3 is next. Okay. And so I create two files. One is cat and one is Sumit. So let's copy the two files data into another file. Okay. So cat first file name is Aman. Second file name is Sumit. Okay. And I want to copy both data into another file, a new file, x greater than, and then the new file name is like dev. I create new file with the dev name and hit enter. So my two files is copied to the dev. So let's see the dev, cat dev. So I write in Aman, today is file editor session, and I write in Sumit, day 2 is there. So, and also I added some lines, day 3 is next. So all the three lines is there. Today is file editor. This is the first file data and this is the second file data. That day 2 is there and day 3 is next. Okay. Okay, so we have one another tool is touch command. We can also use the touch command. Command touch. So touch is most popular for the create empty files, to update the timestamp of the file, to update the timestamp of modification, update the access time. So touch is only used for the create empty files in multiples. Okay, so let's see the touch command. Let's clear the screen. Clear. And give me a minute. So let's see the touch command. Okay. So if I need to create a empty file, then I touch and the file name. Okay. The simple command is that touch and file name. So I create, let's check. I have multiple files. So let's go into some directory. CD music ls again and create some empty file touch. So I'm going to create my mp3 file. Okay, so my mp3 file is created. If I am going to create that one single file touch my.txt, so my.txt is created with one command. If I need to create multiple file at a time, so I can do this command touch A, B, C, D, any name. This is the file name A, B, C, D, and any file name. So we can create with a single command. Okay. Hit enter. My all file is created. Okay. And as I see, touch is used for the timestamp. Okay, so there are three types of timestamp. One is access time. Okay, and second is modify time, and third is change time. So how to see the timestamp? Let's check timestamp. See with the stat command, stat and the file name. my.txt. Sorry, stats. my.txt. Okay, hit enter. So this is the timestamp. This is the size, device, node, all the metadata information related to the my.txt file. This is the UID, who created this, and this is the file permission. Okay, and access, who can access 0644. We will see in the permission management part that what is 0644. Okay, and this is the timestamp of access. 2021 3115. This is as per the machine. Okay, my machine time right now is 516. Okay, and this is the modify time. This is the change time. Okay, if I need to update this time, if I need to update this time, so I can simply update with this command. Touch, and the file name is my.txt. my.txt. So my timestamp is updated. Hit enter. Let's check once again with the stat command, stat my.txt. So here you can see the difference. Access time 514. And here I update the timestamp 517. Okay.
Okay.
And we can also use the option for modify a particular timestamp. If I am going to update only this time, access time, then I use only option with touch hyphen A for the access time update. Okay. So, and my file name is my.txt. So only access time updated. Let's check once again with the stat command. So only change the access time. Okay. So this time is updated, but we can change also this, but it's changed automatically. This is related to the file metadata. That means the file, when it's created, the information, the file type, the file location, the file format, it's all about the metadata. Okay. But we don't need to change this file timestamp. Okay. We only need to update this one and for the this one. Okay.
Okay.
So how to update the modify timestamp? So for the modify timestamp, we can use this option, touch hyphen M and the file name my.txt. Hit enter. So my modify time update. Let's check once again with the stat command. So it's automatic, it's updated 519, and here is 518. And here is 517. Okay.
Okay.
And the third one is Nano Editor. Nano command. Okay. So let's see Nano, how it's work. So Nano is very simple, okay, but we use in our administrator position only for the Vim. We use only the Vim editor tool for our position, okay, for our administrative task, for other. So Vim is very most popular tool to use in file editing. Okay, so let's see about Nano. So if I need to create one file, Nano, and I create one file with the name Aman right now, hit enter. So I am in Nano editor. So I can write anything here that this is cloud Akshay, and anything we can write on the as a data. Okay, so this two and this three. So I write three lines. If I need to go exit, okay. So this is the benefit, because all the commands view you can hear. Okay, so if I need to save and exit, so I press only Control and X. So Control X, let's see what happened. Control and X, it's asking me to save or no or cancel. So I press capital Y for the save. Capital Y for save, capital N for the no, and capital C for the cancel. I press Y, so my data is saved, and it's also asking me for the file name. So I create Aman file, hit enter. My file is created. Let's check with the nano cat with this file. Let's see the data in Aman file nano. So this is the data which we created in the with the nano editor tool. Okay. And we can also overwrite the data with nano, and I again open edit with Aman file, Aman, and here I am write some file. This is 4, this is 5. So if I need to overwrite or write out this data, these two lines, so I need to press Control O, and file name write to Aman. We can also save it to another file, like save as new file. So hit enter. My data is saved. The result is there, wrote 5 lines, and Control X for the exit. Let's check once again, cat nano. So sorry, cat aman. This is all my 5 lines, okay, which I write in Aman file. Okay. And the fourth one is most popular tool is Vim. Okay, so let's see about Vim. Vim is most popular tool, and I open into in Paint. VI or the Vim editor. Okay. So in Vim, VI or the Vim editor, there is 3 mode. First is escape mode. And the second is insert mode. And the third is command mode. Okay. So by default, whenever you open a Vim editor, then that means you are in escape mode. Okay, so let's see that how it's work. So this is my Linux machine, and clear the screen. Let's use the VI tool, Vim editor tool. VIM, I am going to create one file that my file name is Linux. Okay, I create one file with the name of Linux. Okay, so hit enter. My Vim is not installed here, sorry. Let's install Vim. This is the command for the install Vim, and if there is CentOS version or another Linux version, then we use YUM. here instead of apt. So vim, hit enter, password 412. Our vim editor is installed. Okay, so let's clear once again the screen and use vim. The file name is file name is Varun. Let's see, I create one file name is Varun. Okay, so when I hit enter, by default I am in escape mode. Okay, so like there is multiple files. Okay, let's see, I need to open a data file. Let's exit. So there is one data file, means okay, let's enter some data into this file. I for the insert. Okay, and I am right now, I am in escape insert mode. So I am going to insert some data for the practical or the lab. So line 1, line 2, line 3, line 4, Akshay, line 5, Varun. Assume this is the my configuration file. Okay, and I'm working as in a company as a Linux administrator. So how can I find these things? So my manager said to me that need to open the Varun file and edit some thing. So I open this file, and as I say, there is three mode in VI editor: escape mode, insert mode, command mode. By default, we are in the escape mode. If I want to remove this one, this capital or the this word, so I need to press X. X means it's delete the cursor data. Okay. So if I press X, that means I is deleted here. I is deleted. If I again press X, then N is deleted. If I again press X, E, X. So this works as a delete button, X. Okay. And we can remove the pointer word with the X command in escape mode. And if you want to delete the number of character in VI editor, then you have to press the numeric key and then X. If I want to delete these six word in the line, so I press 6 and then press X. So my 6 character is deleted. Okay, so if I want to delete these five character, then I press 5 and then press X. So my 5 character is deleted. Yes. If I want to delete the whole line, so we can press the double D.
Okay.
Double D for the complete line, and we can also delete the multiple lines with DD button. So if I want to delete the 6 lines, okay, then I press 6 and double D, then my 6 line is deleted. Okay. And if I want to go into the bottom, assume I have 1000 number of lines and I move from this cursor, press down button. So it's take time. Okay. and how can I go into the file bottom. So to go into the file bottom, shift plus z, that means you are in bottom. So let's say
okay.
shift and z. Sorry, right now I am in insert mode and I need to escape mode, and now escape mode is enabled and press shift G. That means I am in the line bottom. Okay. So if I want to go into the line bottom, then shift plus G, I'm in line bottom. If I need to go into the top, okay, then I press double G for the top, and to go into the file bottom, then shift plus G. And to undo the changes, you need to only press U for the undo changes. Okay. Before 38 seconds ago, and I again press U for, and again. Okay. So you can, and for the redo the changes, then you have to press Control plus R. So this is the basic command for this tool. Okay.
Suppose if you want to insert a new line.
What?
Suppose if you want to insert a new line.
Okay. Okay. So we need to go into the insert mode. Press I for the insert mode. Whenever I press I, that means I am in insert mode. This line shows that I am in insert mode. Okay. So there are three or four ways to insert some line, some pointer, or some text. Okay. So first, I for the insert some character near the pointer. So, okay. And also, you can use A means, that means I'm going to add it after the cursor. So when I press A, that means I am going to add it after the cursor. Okay. Again, I press A, that means I am going to add it after cursor. Okay. And for O, for the insert a black line below the pointer. Okay, so when I press O, that means insert a blank line. Blank line is entered again. Okay. So if I press again here O, that means blank line is entered. Okay. And if I want to insert a blank line above the cursor, then I need to press shift plus O. Okay. Again, check shift plus O.
Okay. Got it. Yeah.
Got it. And also for the command mode, we need to like there is more data. I insert some more data here. Okay, so if I need to go into the command mode, then I need to press escape and the colon. So that means I am in command mode. Okay, I can also execute the terminal command here. Okay, and let's save this file once again. Let's save and let's check once again with. So right now I am in, by default, in which mode? Escape mode. Okay. And I press escape and colon and you can also use shift plus colon. Okay, shift plus colon you can also use for going to the command mode. Okay, if I entered SE plus NU, that means to set the line number. Entered, that my line number is set. Okay, if I want to delete the line number, then I again go into the command mode, SE no NU. My line number is removed.
Okay.
So, and for the line number, press again escape mode, colon, and 10. That means I am on the 10th number of line. It is directly shortcut that you can go jump to the line. Okay, if I enter like 15, so I am in 15 line number. Okay, if you need to run your terminal command here, then you have to insert one exclamatory sign here, and you can also run your command ls for the listing, hyphen l for the showing file in format. Okay, so let's enter. You can see all your files, okay, within the Vim editor. Okay. And again, let's run one more command. Escape button and press colon for the command mode. Exclamatory sign for run the terminal command. Okay. If I am going to make a directory, mkdir, and the name is cloud. Okay, hit enter. My directory is created. This is the file. Enter, continue. Give me a minute. Let's once again exclamatory sign, touch, and one file is cloud. My file is created. Let's go into the terminal. Escape, colon, WQ, W for the write, Q for the quit, and exclamatory sign for the forcefully. Okay, that means my file is saved, and Q means to quit the editor, exclamatory sign for the forcefully. Okay, if I only write and save this file, so colon W exclamatory sign. So if I want to save this file, that means WQ colon exclamatory sign, hit enter. Ls again, my file is created when I am in the Vim editor tool. Okay. Ls again, ll. So this is the directory which I created, and the time is 5:39, that means 1 minute ago in the terminal. Okay, so mkdir is also executed here, but not shown in the terminal. Okay. And also use, let's go once with Varun file. So this is the file, and shift plus colon for the command mode, W for save, W exclamatory sign, that means save forcefully, Q for the quit without save forcefully, and WQ write and save and quit. Okay, so we use only Vim for editing configuration file. It is very easy. Okay. And it is most popular tool you used in our daily task. Whenever you are on the Linux profile, that means you have to use the Vim editor tool for every configuration file for file editor as a file editor. Any question?
No, no, it's clear. It's
clear it?
Yeah, it's fine for me. No issues.
Okay. So do practice on the file editors. Make some option and make some files with that. Okay. And if any issue, ping me on WhatsApp.